In this video, I'm going to quickly show you how to use the new audio and instrument tracks in FL Studio. This long-awaited feature will allow you to link the mixer, channel rack, and playlist together in such a way that if you change the name or color of something in the mixer, for example, it will also change the playlist and channel rack as well. This feature was implemented in FL Studio version 20.1. In previous versions, this is not possible. These new instrument and audio tracks are mainly a workflow optimization that can save you quite a bit of time in the long run, so I definitely recommend using it. Let me show you how it works. Here we have some stems. Let's drag them in and drop them here. You will get asked if you want to create audio clips, audio tracks, or instrument tracks. These are stems, so we'll choose audio tracks. Now they will be linked. Notice how the name also shows up in the mixer. If I change the name and color here, it also changes in the playlist and vice versa. This is more in line with how it works with other DAWs. This is something that people used to complain about quite often about FL Studio, so I'm glad to see this feature is finally implemented. Next, let's have a look at the instrument tracks as well. If I right-click here and select Instrument Track, then we can choose a VST from the list. Now, if I change the name here, it will change the name in the mixer and the channel rack as well. It doesn't matter where I change the name or color now. It will apply the changes everywhere automatically. Another benefit from this is that you can now just double-click here and it will bring up the VST for you. Notice how it will also automatically select the corresponding mixer track and channel in the channel rack. This goes for audio tracks as well. This small letter in the upper left corner here shows what kind of track it is. If you use this method, you won't waste time naming and coloring things anymore. In earlier versions, if you didn't load your sounds in the correct way in the first place, you would often end up spending a lot of time naming and coloring things three times over. Needless to say, this would be quite tedious, especially if you're the kind of person who likes to work quickly and just throws a lot of stuff in there. In that case, you would usually end up spending a lot of time naming and coloring things afterwards in order to try and keep your project organized. From now on, if you use this method, you might save yourself quite a bit of time in the long run. Last but not least, let me show you how to convert existing tracks to audio or instrument tracks. If the track contains an audio clip and you want to turn it into an audio track, just right-click here and select Track Mode again. Now you'll see a list of inserts. These are mixer inserts, so just choose the mixer track you want to link it to, and you're done. If you want to turn a track into an instrument track, the procedure is almost the same. Right-click here, Track Mode, and then select the instrument track. Now go to Use Existing Channel and select the VST you want to link from the list. This can help your projects be more organized, and in turn, that can save you quite a bit of time over the course of the project. That said, there are some situations where you might want to stick with the old way of doing it instead, like if you prefer to put a lot of different sounds all over the place, for example. But if you prefer to work in a more linear and organized way, with one track dedicated to one sound and so on, then you'll find this really helpful. If you want to know more about what's new in the latest versions of FL Studio, then you should check out my video reviews. You can find the link to those videos in the descriptions below. I'd like to thank our Patreons for their ongoing support. And as always, if there's any specific tutorial you'd like us to make, or if you have a question, just let us know in the comments below. Also, make sure to check out the links below if you need feedback on your music, mixing, mastering, and so on. Thanks for watching.